Yeah, we should have paid them to, like, pretend like they knew who I was. What's up, guys? Yesterday I had my first show, and I did not have time to prep a song for this week, so we are doing a 10,000 subscriber Q&A in place of it. Hope you don't mind. Anyways, let's get right into it because we don't have a lot of light left. Ben, hit me.
James Burke asks, what made you want to do what you do?
When I was 10 years old, my brother gave me his first guitar. He's been playing guitar for 25 years now. He was my biggest influence growing up to be a musician. So when he gave me his first guitar for my 10th birthday, I started playing, and the second I started playing, I learned a couple bar chords for Iron Man, and I just fell in love. It was an epiphany type moment, like, this is what I'm gonna do for the rest of my life, so. And we're finally doing it as a full-time job.
What is your biggest pet peeve?
Mouth sounds, or people chewing with their mouth open. Hearing people chew, and hearing people breathe really shallow breaths. I don't wanna piss anybody off with this video.
Did you ever think that you'd be a rising star in music at this point in your life?
At this point, no. I thought it'd be way earlier. I was super cocky. When I was, like, 13 or so, I've been playing guitar just 8 hours a day for like 3 years, and I mean like literally 8 hours every single day. It was just World of Warcraft and guitar. That was my life. And at that point, I would always look up like 13-year-old guitarists to see if I was better than them, and I was super competitive, but I was just really cocky, and so I thought I would be a star a lot earlier. I'm glad that none of it happened until now. I'm a lot more grounded. I'm very humbled by how long it's taking and the gradual process of things, not getting industry connections to put me on or anybody else to put me on, doing it myself, learning all the aspects of business, of marketing shows, of marketing myself, making the music, production of music, engineering, mixing, mastering, rapping, playing guitar, piano, chord structure, music theory, ear training, choir, everything. Everything that I've gone through has made me a lot more appreciative of where I am.
Kelvin 9815 asked if you're bisexual.
No. Moving on.
How old are you?
22. Just knock these ones out.
I don't know about you, but who's your favorite rapper?
Eminem and Tech N9ne, half and half.
Sarah K7865 asks, do you get a lot of hate for what you do?
Oh, tons. If you ever read my comments on Facebook, they're a lot nicer on YouTube, actually, because that's like my core fan base every time. So if you ever read my comments on Facebook, you'll know. You'll know, I get a lot. I don't delete them.
GSM Records asks, how long did it take you to come up? Still on the come up,
yeah,
man.
I don't know, 12 years to get to where I am, and I don't feel like I'm where I need to be. I mean, it varies for each person. Don't worry about how long it takes. Just enjoy the process, enjoy the journey.
Who is your hero?
My hero? My mom.
Cabela07 asks, what is a favorite song that you've made?
Probably My Own Time. I jammed My Own Time.
Is there anything you would change about your life and why?
I'd have a dishwasher and a personal chef. How I got started into singing, I started rapping before I started singing. So in high school, I started rapping. I started doing battle rap after class. So I didn't really battle anybody. I battled one person once, and then I just kind of walked around trying to get other people to battle me. I'd just be like, oh, bro, you want to battle right now? But I started singing in choir in college. I didn't really think of myself as a singer, but my music theory teacher came up to me and was like, you have a really low voice. We could totally use you for the choir. And then the choir teacher approached me and was like, we need more basses. You should join choir. So I joined choir. Did that for about a year and a half, along with ear training, which made me sing a couple times a week as well. That's how I got started into singing. Now I have a personal vocal coach, but that's only been going on for about 2 months, and I'm really, really trying to improve.
Ellie Luis asked if you have any brothers or sisters.
Nope, none that I like. I have three.
Sunid asks, what's your goal in life?
Well, number one is to live a comfortable lifestyle off of music. My goals always change, though. So once I have that, then it's gonna be buy a Lamborghini.
She asks, what are you doing for your birthday? Your birthday kind of just happened.
What did you do
for your birthday?
Hung out with the fam bam, ate sausages, went to the arcade, kicked ass at this video game called Walking Dead with my brother, and pretty much just kicked it with the fam. Super chill birthday. We got froyo. I got super sick to my stomach because I ate too much sugar, and that was it.
Carissa Lynn asks, did you ever play any sports when you were in school?
Yes. I played a bunch, but none of them very well. I played basketball for like 6 years up until high school, and then I wasn't good enough to actually make the high school team, so I did all the sports that didn't force me to actually be good at anything. Cross country, swimming, water polo, wrestling for like 2 months, and I think that covers everything I did in high school. They just let you in.
Who is your muse?
My muse?
Me, obviously.
He's in the video. It's him.
Terry Brown asks, where are you from?
Modesto, California, 209. Wannabe Bay Area, represent.
Who's your favorite YouTuber?
No, favorite YouTuber is myself, son. I'll only watch myself. Probably Phil DeFranco.
You watch a lot of Phil DeFranco.
Every day, probably for like the past 2 years, so. I'd say Philip DeFranco.
Tara Childs asks, what inspires you to keep moving forward with your music?
Fans definitely inspire me. Seeing the support on each video I drop, my brother, but mostly my self-expectation. I'm just pretty determined. I don't need to really be inspired by something. It's just a habit by this point. I just get up, I make music, I do what I do, and it's just what I love to do. It's really easy. I don't really need to be inspired to do it.
Evie Causey asks, what keeps you going when you feel like you want to quit?
I don't know about quit, but when you're just feeling super down on yourself, positive feedback definitely helps during those times. And then remembering why you do something. For me, I just love writing music. Since I was 10 years old, I could just envision myself on stage. I could envision creating music for people. But something that really inspires me to keep going when I get down on myself, which is pretty often, when people send me messages saying that I helped them out in some way. Music has definitely been the thing that's there for me my entire life, when nothing else is. I want my music to be able to do that for somebody else, and whenever it does, whenever I get a message from one of you guys saying that my music has helped you in some way, that makes me think that I just can't quit.
Would you ever make a song or a cover with a beatboxer?
Hell yeah. Yeah, I think that'd be pretty fun. Beatboxer hit me up recently, but never got back to me with an actual beat, but I would definitely be down to just do like a super hip-hop beatbox type thing. Chris Webby does it on his albums, and he just has like college cyphers, and I think it's a pretty sick idea.
Alyssa Biondo asks, I'm from Chicago, and I want to know what your favorite part about the trip was.
Ooh, Chicago was so dank. I'd say actually the architecture. We did a boat tour. There was a guy who told us all the history of every huge building and how they've been torn down and rebuilt and just all the history of all the architecture. And that was one of the sickest things ever. I was also really drunk for it, so that might have had something to do with it. But it was so, so cool. The architecture is beautiful. The food there is amazing. Lou Malnati's is definitely my favorite restaurant there. Had the best pasta I've ever had at a restaurant. Deep dish pizzas, way better than I thought it'd be.
Do you see yourself doing this in 10 years, or do you think your style will change?
Doing this, doing music, yes. Will my style change? Absolutely. Go listen to my music from a year ago and listen to my music now. It changes constantly. I think the music that an artist makes in a certain time period is kind of like a chapter of their life, and that's what they're going through at the time, and they write about it, and they write about what they know, and that's how it's authentic. But that's gonna change. My life is gonna change. I'm gonna write about different things, especially once I start touring and doing stuff like that. I'll definitely evolve. Hopefully it gets better.
What is your favorite time of the year?
Halloween to January 1st. That's the best time of the year. I love the rain. It's like overcast and rainy. It just makes me feel not guilty at all about staying in my house and writing music all day. But when it's super sunny, I feel bad. Also, Halloween and Christmas are my favorite holidays. Love Christmas. It's just an excuse to get together with the family. Same as Thanksgiving. Get a lot of time off from work or school or whatever you're doing. So that's always dank. Definitely just those 2 months. Halloween to January 1st, New Year's.
Well, thank you so much, YouTube. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the 10,000 subscriber Q&A.
We'll be back on track next week with our regular weekly videos.
See you when we hit 100K.
See you at a million. Next Q&A at 100 million subs, so make sure you subscribe.